whether you're aware of it or not. We actually have fewer police officers today than we had 10 years ago, yet we are being stretched in so many different ways that is a challenge for us. There is such intense pressure to try and get the job done and deal with the issues that they have to deal with limited resources. Several months ago, at about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, the dispatcher was telling one of our field supervisors that they had 30 police calls holding that needed addressed. And I can tell you, we didn't have anywhere close to that number of officers even working at that time. We ask our officers to work overtime often. Our ability to do preventive patrol, where we drive through a neighborhood and we talk to neighbors and we get to know a little bit about the areas that we work. When we're going from call to call to call, those opportunities go away. A suspicious vehicle driving through your neighborhood where you might call and because you have a concern, those are the types of things that are difficult sometimes for us to get to simply because we are so busy. And those are the types of calls we really want to get to, because we know that if we're able to respond to a suspicious activity, we might keep it from being a burglary or a theft or something like that. So I think that is the probably the frustration and the most difficult part of being a police officer today is having to try and deal with all the pressures and all the calls that they are confronted with. And there really isn't anything routine about police work. We never know what we're going to be confronted with. We never know what we're going to be facing when we go on a call. We go on the most easy to handle calls. Somebody can't find their car, to a high-risk search warrant where we have to take a SWAT team to deal with the issue because the danger that's present is so bad. We deal with people in crisis. We deal with people that are having the worst day of their lives. And sometimes those things can be dealt with quickly and efficiently, but sometimes they can't. Sometimes it takes a great deal of time to help somebody through a problem that they're having, whether it's a mental health issue or a domestic violence issue, or they've been the victim of a crime. It doesn't matter. That is where the challenges of policing comes in. The stresses and the pressures of dealing with the easy things to changing in a matter of seconds to dealing with the really, really tough, dangerous things that a community cares about so deeply. I think that's one of the challenges that we have. We have been blessed with a community that supports us, that stands up for us, and lets our officers know how much they're appreciated. It is our job every single day to earn that respect that we have. And I think the wonderful thing about our organization is we have always been a department that responds well to the community needs. We have always tried to be a leader in technology and doing things a smart way to make sure that we are putting the public's money to good use. And I know we'll continue to do that. And while I'm proud of so many different things and that have happened to me and I've been around throughout my career, the fact that we have incredible employees that go out of their way to make sure that when we show up, things are going to get better. That's what they're all about.